Oh, good lord. Okay.
Extremely helpful.
I will take this man to the medical office.
Okay. Oh, my.
Well.
I'm too heavy, at least. Sorry, can you hear me?
Yep. Sorry, you just would knocked out of me for a second there.
Don't worry. Ni hao, can I have some help?
Oh, yeah.
Ni hao?
Yes, sorry. Put him on the bed.
Thank you. I think he is okay, just a little winded.
Alright, let me just check him over, just in case.
Of course. Sir, are you okay with me leaving you here?
Yeah, you're good.
Good luck.
Be conscious.
Get well soon.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm here. I'm with you.
Alright, I'm just gonna check you over and get you comfortable, okay? Just want to make sure that you haven't been shot or stabbed or just anything at this point in time. Looks like you got some bruising on the chest here. Just want to make sure nothing's broken or fractured. Otherwise, that's going to cause some issues. Some bruising. How are you feeling? You feeling a little dizzy? Feel like throwing up? Anything like that?
No, nothing too bad. Just, I was a little bit winded.
Alright. No, nice and gentle. Yeah, I'm not seeing anything broken, which is a good sign. Yeah, just got some bruising on your chest, okay?
Yeah, that sounds about right. I was trying to hop on my horse, and I guess something must have scared him. He kicked out and just clipped me.
Oh, yes. They have a habit of doing that when they get spooked.
I guess next time I'll announce my presence a bit better.
Yep. Oh, just avoid walking behind him, or at least keep your distance, okay?
Or that. Good pointers. Thank you.
Oh, you're very welcome. All right. Well, if you have any trouble breathing or anything like that, come and try and find us, okay?
You will see me right back if that's the case.
All right. Perfect. That's a good... Well, bad that you have to, but good that you're going to come to us.
I mean, whenever I get out of injury, I feel that the medical offices tend to be a good place to go.
Yeah, they generally are. Alright, well, if there's nothing else, I'll let you go on your merry way. Just, yeah, if you have any trouble breathing or feel dizzy, come to us, okay?
Will do. Thanks for your help.
Oh, good. Stay safe. Watch out for horses, please.
Absolutely. Thank you again. Oh, that was so painful. I think Pat's just gonna take a minute. Right. We'll do one more ride over to Rhodes. check for Mr. Tulliver. And if he's not there, we're going the fuck to sleep. It's starting to become a real pain in my ass there, Hales. Gentle. You son of a bitch. Next time, I'm turning you into glue. I mean, I love you, but fuck. I finally caught my breath. You do the running. I would have given you an easy ride, boy, but you kicked me. I mean, what else am I gonna do? Walk? Maybe sail across next time. Get myself a boat so you can't kick me. I guess at least now I learn horses don't like to be approached from behind. Hello. You'd think I'd remember that from our days on the ranch, but I guess Pa must have broken them well. They never gave a shit. You're a different breed, aren't you? True horse of the crossing. Hello, sir. isn't like home. At least it's sort of starting to feel like a home. That's something. You must be sick of this robo by now, but I just need to go through here one last time. Just for my own peace of mind. Hello, sir. I guess I spooked him. Yeah, I might be a little bit tired. Hello, sir. When we get to Rhodes, I'm going to hit you up. I'm gonna need you to be calm, okay? You kick anybody, I swear. Yeah, you might be thinking, you're really milking this, but in all honesty, I've just lost a little bit of trust in you. Makes me a little sad. Morning. Morning. All right. Last leg. One final checkpoint, and then... Well, then we just gotta go. Hello, miss. All right, let's go in and check for Mr. Tulliver. What in the heck? Okay. Mr. Tulliver? Mr. Tulliver? Atticus. Maybe he's simply too scared. I don't know. Well, sir. Mr. Tulliver, you in there, perchance? No. No, I didn't think so. Well, it was worth a shot anyway. Sorry, sir, I didn't mean to yell past you. God damn it, Atticus. You had better be safe. Hello, sir. I should have studied his horse better. Should have paid more attention. Obviously, I didn't expect him to run into trouble so soon, but yeah, I could have paid closer attention to his horse. I could have. I don't know, something. Then I would have found him more easily. Those riders are going pretty fast, boy. Let's go. I don't know who they were and what they wanted, but we don't have to find out either. All right. They're past us now. I don't know what that was, and I don't want to find out. Yeah. I know what you're thinking, Hales. You're thinking... Well, your horse, you're probably not thinking about much, to be fucking fair, but... If you were a person, you'd probably say, Pat, you know this young man for all of 2 days. Relax your butt cheeks. And that is a fair comment. But then you fail to take into account that I can't lose anyone. Not even people I've known we met. Especially to some cult bullshit. Preacher always told me you're gonna fight the devil all your life. Well, here's my thing. Here's me fighting the devil. Right, isn't that how it works? Nah, I'm just rambling. Who knows anymore? What I do need is rest. Must just be the way things go in the crossing. We'll have a quick peek inside the saloon, see who's there. And then we're gonna go to bed. Because we're overdue. Not him. You can't convince me otherwise. I know his hat. think I saw a bartender in there, but not the one we've been talking to. You're a pain in my ass. But you did good. Most of today. Night, Hales. See you tomorrow. We tried to find Mr. Tulliver, but unfortunately, we could not. Hopefully he gets back to us. I can speak. Hopefully he gets back to us through telegram, but we'll all find that out next time. See you later, everybody. Have a good one. Until next time, take good care of yourselves and of others. Bye-bye.